Hey, what's up, guys? So there's some crazy rumors floating around the internet about different amazing things you can do with etch-a-sketches, and I wanted to know if that's true or not, so I got Lincoln and Dan here with me from What's Inside, and we're gonna bust these things open, extract the contents, and see what we can do with them, because you asked for it.
I'm Lincoln, this is Dan from a channel called What's Inside.
You've been seeing our channel, we cut stuff open to see what's inside of things, and we decided that we wanted to cut open an etch-a-sketch because people asked us for it.
We actually cut open one of these already, and we found a fine silver material inside here, so we're gonna go experiment with this and find out what we can make it do or not do. And you guys, I'm gonna be free reign in my workshop here to cut these things open and show your viewers exactly what it looks like.
Now this metallic powder looks really interesting, and it's hard to tell exactly what it is. I looked it up on the internet, and the common belief is that it's aluminum powder. Now I mix these powders together in a ratio of 1:3, which should be an ideal ratio for this kind of composition, but it's not going to be able to light off with a match or a barbecue igniter. We're going to have to use something quite a bit hotter, like a regular garden sparkler. Now theoretically, if we touch the lit sparkler right into the center of this pile, it should like ignite and turn into a big ball of flames and fire and all kinds of awesomeness. So let's see if that really happens or not. Now I cannot get this to light off even with the sparkler, but what's really interesting is if you look closely down at the pile, you can actually see white bubbles and balls starting to pop up out of the metal. And from the smell in the air and how badly this smells, I'm pretty sure that those are little styrofoam balls. Okay, so none of these are working. I've tried four different ratios, four different compositions, and we can't get any of them to even make so much as a spark. Now that does look pretty cool, but even with all that heat and all that firepower, this thing is not even so much as making a spark. So if this isn't gonna light off with the blowtorch and sparklers, I'm pretty sure that there's really no way we're gonna make this thing work with etch-a-sketch powder. But I'm not gonna let you go home empty-handed. I do have a backup plan and a whole bag of aluminum, so let's go upstairs to my table where I can show you the real way to make thermite. I got a bag of aluminum powder off the internet, and I've got this bag of rust powder, and we're gonna need to mix them together in a 1:3 ratio. So we're gonna start off with a pretty small batch. Let's do 15 grams of aluminum powder, and then another 50 grams of the rust powder. So our total weight should be 65 grams, and that should be just about perfect. All right, here we go.
First thing I'm going to do is just pluck this off a little
bit.
Look at that.
Whoa.
Look at how it makes like
a hole in there.
Yeah, it just totally melted that concrete, didn't it? Yeah, there's a couple more little bubbles. Wow.
It's just amazing to me how long it stayed hot afterward. Is it still hot?
Yeah, it's still warm. You don't feel it?
It's been about 15 minutes.
Oh, yeah. Dad, hold this.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it's a little toasty.
Hold this.
What does it look like inside of it?
Here we go.
What?
Look at that.
Look at those little bubbles.
We got little balls. Are those hot enough?
Look how heavy this is. Feel this.
Makes little craters.
It's like a little meteorite. It does look like a meteorite.
Yeah. We just made a meteorite.
It's hot.
We have just created iron from rust.
Wow.
Sweet.
That's actually really fascinating.
Okay, here we go.
There's burning glass. I'm sorry, I kind of screwed up the shot.
That's perfect.
Man, check this out. Feel that on the back. This has been about, what, 10 minutes since we set that up? Yeah. And that is still very, very warm. Like, you can't even hold your hand on it without pulling it away. Look at this, the glass is melted. Look at that. That is actually, that is all liquid.
That's marshmallow.
Yeah, that's marshmallow. But look at that, that is a piece of glass and it's welded straight to the concrete.
That was epic. I mean, look at this one.
Oh my gosh.
So here's a piece of glass and then on the bottom.
Yes, it's all encrusted with iron. Wow, check out the back. It looks kind of like a geode, a crystal geode.
It does.
Look at that, right there.
Make your own geodes.
All right, so guys, we tried our best, but we just could not make thermite out of etch-a-sketch powder. We used quite a bit of powder. We did a lot of different experiments, and maybe we just couldn't figure it out. Maybe one of you is a little bit smarter than us, but we thought to finish off this video, we're gonna give these etch-a-sketches a proper send-off, and we're gonna put this powder to good use. Even though we couldn't get it to work, we brought some extras.
This is definitely gonna be dangerous. I like to call this the Etch-a-Sketch Tower of Doom.
All right, I'm thinking this is all the leftover thermite I've got. Let's just dump that down in there. That's a good pile.
What about that one?
Then we got this stuff that actually came from the Etch-a-Sketch. We're gonna do an honorary thermite burning here with that one.
This could not be a good idea.
And then just to top it all off, I got a glass full of thermite, and we're gonna set that right in the middle.
Oh my gosh, this is gonna be crazy.
And let's see what happens.
Oh, this is so dangerous.
All right, everybody run away.
Run away! Fire in the hole! Get close. It's almost there.
Oh, you'll know.
This is my carbon dioxide fire extinguisher that we made dry ice cream with.
Project was so much bigger than I thought it was going to be, and I should have known that because we've been watching Grant Thompson's videos for years. And if you guys haven't subscribed to his channel, go subscribe, watch some of the videos because there are some other crazy things on there.
Nice, Dan, I appreciate that. And make sure you go check out the What's Inside channel as well, because they filmed a whole separate video on the Etch-a-Sketch that complements this one really well. It's really cool. You get to see how an Etch-a-Sketch works and what's inside it. So thanks again for coming out, you guys.
Yeah, that was fun. We gotta do this again.
This is an awesome collaboration. You guys are awesome.
Great.
And looking forward to doing something again with you in the future.
That was fun.
All right, thanks for watching, you guys. Appreciate your support, and we'll see you again in the next video. Talk to you then.
Hey, what's up guys? I made this video because you asked for it, and I'm taking more requests right now. So what do you want to see me do next? Well, put your wackiest ideas in the comments and let's see what kind of fun we can have with the next video. I'll see you there.